Hallo meine Lieben und herzlich willkommen bei einer weiteren Folge Super Seducer 2. Wir fangen mit dem Spiel jetzt an und wir haben ja schon Super Seducer 1 sozusagen gespielt. Schaut gerne mal unten in der Videoverlinkung, da seht ihr es auf jeden Fall, falls ihr natürlich erst diesen Teil sehen wollt. Und wir fangen direkt mal an. So, ich habe gerade nochmal nachgeschaut und leider gibt es das nur auf Englisch und nicht auf Deutsch. Es ist natürlich jetzt etwas doof für ein paar Leute hier, die jetzt nicht so gut Englisch verstehen, aber ich hoffe, dass ihr alles in allem trotzdem das versteht, worum es hier eigentlich geht, denn wir wollen die Mädels aufreißen. So, und das Goal ist eine Nummer, Sex or kill your enemies. Ich glaube, das versteht jeder, auch jeder Deutsche. Also, wir drücken mal auf Play.
Arthur, I'm hungry, man. Let's go to the restaurant.
Wo ist denn da ein Restaurant? Okay. In einem Tank zu einem Restaurant zu fahren, das,
Arthur, we fucked up the grass again, dude.
Das macht auch nicht jeder. Und er hat ein bisschen den Rasen nicht so geil. Das sah sehr krass gespielt aus. Sehr gut. Schauspielerisch 1A. Sehr trockene Lippen. Oh. Das gefällt ihm. Na, oh. Ich glaube, es war selber sehr lustig für die, das zu drehen. Die Oma so. Und er so, oh. Hübsches Ding. Okay. Was machen wir denn? A. Catch her attention non-verbally. B. Go and tell her that she caught your eye. And you can join her for a few minutes. Also, A, man soll ihre Aufmerksamkeit erlangen, nonverbal sozusagen. B, einfach hingehen und sagen, hey, du bist mir aufgefallen, kann ich mich zu dir setzen für ein paar Minuten? Oder C, use the genius conversation starter from that YouTube guy. Von dem einem Video etwas sich anschauen. D ist etwas sehr Perverses, das könnt ihr schon selber lesen. E. Don't approach her at all. Eat a kumquat. Ich bin mir ehrlich gesagt nicht sicher, was das ist. Aber, was nehmen wir denn mal? Wir fangen. Die Frage ist, wie gehen wir dieses Spiel jetzt an? Machen wir Quatsch? Oder spielen wir es richtig? Ich würde erst das probieren. A. Hm. Ganz schön windig.
Hey, listen, I was just sitting there. Saw you. And you caught my eye, so I thought I'd come and say hi. How are you doing?
Hi. I'm fine.
That's good to hear.
Coming for a spot of lunch.
Ah, lovely.
Hmm.
This is a nice way to start, because if you catch her attention before you actually walk up, she has a chance to kind of get used to the fact that you're going to be talking to her. And if you kind of just walk up and she hasn't noticed you, it's a bit of a surprise when you suddenly start talking. So it's a better way when you can do it.
Yeah, I think it's also a little bit romantic.
Wie?
Sam Richards.
Hi, I'm Lottie.
Wir haben richtig gemacht.
Charlotte, yeah?
Yes, it is.
Ah, lovely to meet you.
Good to meet you too.
Hello, are you ready to order?
Wo wird das eigentlich produziert? In Osteuropa oder so? Nichts, also nicht um das Böse zu meinen, aber man hört das schon sehr raus. Tee, Kuchen und irgendwas für sie. Hey Babe, the usual please. B is auch order tea, cake, shirt of confidence, something for her. Also, Tee, Kuchen, Alkohol und irgendwas für sie. Tell her not to bother, you are in an important conversation. Das ist sehr böse. You know what? Everything on this menu sucks. Let's go back to my place. Oh, das ist jetzt sehr doof. Ich würde, glaube ich, wieder A nehmen.
So, do you already know what you would like?
I'm going to be naughty today. I'm going to go for the chocolate cheesecake.
Very nice.
And a lovely cup of tea, please.
Okay, and I'm going to have the cherry cake, please, and English breakfast tea, but no milk.
Okay.
Thank you.
Oh!
What is the latest or earliest time that I can have champagne?
Oh.
No, that's a question.
But if a guy came to sit with you, you wouldn't ask him to buy you champagne?
No, but if he offered me a glass of champagne at 5:30 in the evening, that's quite romantic. Or just a straight espresso.
Hey.
Sorry.
Ich finde es sehr lustig, dass sie sehr direkt diesen Vorwurf mit Rassismus und so versuchen zu widerlegen, indem sie so welche Namen einbauen und sowas. Sehr lustig. Ich würde ihn ignorieren.
Sorry about that. Just someone messaging me. Let me put that on silent. I never do that. I never have my phone on when I'm talking to someone.
No, it's understandable.
You know what, it's such a lovely day and you're dressed amazingly. It's all summery, but it's got something to it, like a real interesting style you have.
Thank
you.
Very nice. It's really nice of you to say.
Well, it's true.
So, what do you do? I'd like to know more about Richard.
Also, ich habe mir gerade mal alles kurz durchgelesen. Make a joke, then tell the truth. I work for, oh mein Gott, das kann ich gar nicht sagen, Company, make YouTube video truth, distract her, do the ring finger. Kann man machen, das mache ich jetzt lustig.
Well, never mind that, hang on, I just noticed your ring. That's quite interesting. Let me see.
Yeah, it's my grandma's.
Oh, yeah. Well, do you know something? There's this interesting thing that I heard about where they say that whatever finger you wear the ring on says something about your personality.
Okay,
do you want to hear?
Yeah, I do.
All right.
What do you think about me?
Well,
the thumb, if you had the ring on that finger, the thumb, it's all connected to Greek mythology. So the thumb is Poseidon, and he was the only god that didn't live in Mount Olympus. So it's about strength and independence.
Okay.
So that's pretty interesting.
Right.
The second finger is Zeus.
Wow.
So obviously god. This is like power, mm-hmm. decisiveness, leader, all of this stuff. Now, we do your one?
Yeah.
The next one is Dionysus. So it's the god of wine and fun and, you know, all
oh,
of that
I
stuff.
Oh, I like that. I yeah. really like that. I am like a goddess
that you?
Of fun. Yeah, I love being so much fun and I love wine.
There you go.
Yeah.
Oh, perfect. So spot on. The next one, obviously, this is like the ring finger when you get married and stuff. So it's Aphrodite, obviously.
Oh,
so goddess of love. And,
yeah,
yeah,
I like
all
that.
Of that nice stuff. And then the final one, Aries, war. So you know these guys that have pinky rings and sometimes they're
yeah.
a little bit
fiery.
Know, troublesome, fiery.
Yes. Yeah.
So that's
stubborn,
that one.
Actually.
So it worked for you then? Pretty
yes.
interesting.
Yeah, I can definitely relate to that.
Yeah, and oh, you asked me my job, right? So mm-hmm. yeah, I'm doing this pharmaceuticals thing and yeah. then I also make YouTube videos as well.
Really?
So a bit of, yeah.
What? YouTube videos?
Yeah, you know, just all different kinds of videos, put them on YouTube, try and get views, advertising and all that stuff.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Very interesting.
Ja, jetzt wollen wir aber auch mehr
so
über sie wissen.
This is one of those routines, and if she Googles it, she could find that it's a pickup routine, which is not good. However, having said that, it's quite interesting. You're talking about her jewelry and doing a little cold read, and it's kind of interesting. It basically...
Where you
yeah,
wear the rings on your
yeah.
fingers.
Do you wear a ring? None. Never.
What does that say about me?
I don't think I learned that one, actually.
On
you only say it if she has rings. There you go.
Okay.
Otherwise, you need a different routine.
Tja.
Well, she's going to find out
palm
because everyone
reading.
Googles it.
Palm reading is what I would do.
What if she knows how to palm read?
Oh, shit.
And you say it wrong. Why can't you just be honest? Why can't guys just be honest? How hard?
Yeah.
Okay. Wir haben Fehler gemacht.
And what do you do for work?
Oh, well, I don't really need to work, but I do a spot of acting.
Ah, lovely. You know,
yeah.
something interesting I've noticed, I've met some actors, and they're always very interesting people because they're empathetic, and that's...
Absolutely.
I think it's because when they're acting, they have to portray all these emotions, so
uh-huh.
they just understand...
Oh, die haben schon den Kuchen übrigens.
Emotions. They can read
they
body
do.
Language. And
yeah, and that's what I love. I just love studying people and their nature, and it's a really good way to connect with people on a really deep level. That not necessarily you can do in reality.
Yeah, and actors.
Und es ist nicht immer so windig übrigens.
They wouldn't connect with people, but because of this, you can really.
You can
get
feel
in
it,
there.
And
yeah.
you can get the vibe. It's amazing.
Excellent.
Sie ist echt hübsch.
Cool job, actually.
Yeah, it is. It's nice to dip in and out, obviously.
So, hey, do you recognize her in the car?
Yes, I do.
I think.
Who is she?
I think it's that famous Russian model. What's her name? I don't know, but
God,
yeah.
she's beautiful, isn't she?
Yeah, not bad.
Wow.
Was würde jeder Boy denn jetzt wohl machen? Würde er mit dieser etwas älteren Frau im Café weiter quatschen? Oder gehen wir zu dem russischen Model, was super famous? Das ist jetzt eine Frage, die ihr euch alle stellen müsst. Und ich glaube, 60% von euch würden zu dem Mädel im Auto gehen. Aber... Wir bleiben bei dem Mädchen.
Yeah, modeling's all right, but acting's much more interesting, right?
Yeah,
So much more varied.
Mhm. It is as well.
Sie ist einfach weitergefahren?
You just have to stare.
Yeah.
But acting, you have to feel.
We have to show certain personality and be different characters.
Wow, jetzt versuchen wir uns rauszureden.
Feel that emotion.
Aber er regretted es sofort.
So you do your acting, does that mean you're more interested than usual in, I don't know, like TV shows and stuff? Do you watch TV?
Well,
oh,
thank you.
Ah, jetzt kommt erst der Kuchen.
I
Hä?
Silicon Valley, actually.
That's Is that your favourite?
At the moment, it's basically like really intelligent guys that love technology.
Are you like intelligent guys?
I do. I love intelligent guys. I think you're.
Ja, wer mag die nicht?
Well, I'm not a programmer, but I've got my own kind of business intelligence
ways,
and street smarts.
Well, I think, you know, I can relate to the intelligent side because I'm quite intelligent. So I need to end up with someone.
Keiner sagt das eigentlich von sich selber, oder?
So yeah, I just love the way they invent things. And I think I'd be quite good at that as well. So yeah, that's Silicon Valley's way. What about you?
I'm watching Handmaiden. Have you seen that? The Handmaid's Tale?
Oh, I've heard of that.
Yeah, that one is messed up actually. It's quite it's not a comedy obviously. It's like some dystopian parallel future where everything goes wrong, where women, when the birth rate just drops near zero, and they round up all of the women that can still have babies, and they kind of put them with the important men to mate.
Wow.
And it's quite messed up, but it's really, really good and interesting. Have you seen it?
No, I haven't.
Oh, you should check it out.
Yeah, sounds quite interesting. I'd have to see if I like it. Mm-hmm. You know, it might be a little bit for me, but. Ja, I can always see.
Okay, wir beenden mal mit diesem tollen Gespräch diese Folge und wir sehen uns in der nächsten Folge wieder. Bis dahin, ciao.